It's fantastic to have you tonight. You're looking forward to the film?
Very much so, yeah. Very excited. I was seeing James and Fassbender.
Big X-Men fan? Is it a franchise that you followed?
It's not a franchise I've followed particularly, but I'm kind of up for those types of films. I'm trying to be diplomatic now. There's easy watchers.
I mean, the superhero genre has really exploded in the last few years. Is it something you've ever been interested in? Something you'd fancy for yourself at some point?
I remember actually, a long, long time ago, I auditioned to play Superman, as did every other adult male in London. Yes, it would be a lot of fun. Bowling about on green screen, pretending you have powers you don't possess. I'm up for that.
And if you were to have one power, what would you most want?
God, this is. I should have known you were going to ask this. I should have known. I'm going to probably say time travel.
Talking about your real life powers, your awesome acting powers, what are you using those for at the moment? Coming up next for you in 2014.
I've just come to the tail end of a film with Kelsey Grammer. So we're just finishing up, tying up the loose ends of that, called Breaking the Bank, which is a comedy about the banking collapse in the city. And then in a couple of weeks, I've got the beginning of the third series of Bad Education, which I do with Jack Whitehall.
Starting, I mean, talking about working with Kelsey, I mean, what's that been like? I mean, obviously a small screen legend in so many ways.
Yeah, a small screen legend, and it's bizarre to work with somebody. I mean, you know, I've been very fortunate enough to work with a lot of really amazing people who have huge renown across the world. But Kelsey was one I could never have predicted. And he was extraordinary, yeah. Amazing man, very professional and very lovely. And although I think, you know, he was doing the film just to have a little bit of a holiday in England. He's very, very funny, and it was great fun, yeah.
Talking about funny, what are you looking forward to about the third season of Bad Education? Because your character, he's a bit of a buffoon on that, really, to be honest.
Yeah, I mean, we've got the read-through on Friday, and I haven't seen any scripts. All I know from the producer is that my various costumes, because I was like a prawn in the last series, and like an elf, my costumes get worse. So that should be both exciting and demeaning in equal measure.
Is there anything else on the horizon, or is that it for now?
Well, that will finish as summertime. Then I'll have a little summer break, and then hopefully into the theatre, although that's not confirmed yet. So, trying to do a play a year.
We love seeing you on stage. Why do you keep coming back to it? What is it you get from that you don't get from screen work?
Working down the road from my house. You get an instant reaction from the audience every night, and people always say to me when about filming is that, you know, does it not get repetitive having to do take after take and stuff like that? Of course, I don't have to do a lot of takes. They try to, and it's kind of the opposite really, because they say. Sorry, they say on stage, how do you do the same thing every night, you know? And it's completely different every night, because you've got a completely different set of people in the room, if people have come. And so the whole atmosphere is different. So although you're saying the same lines and playing the same part that you've rehearsed for several weeks, it's completely different, and that's what's exciting. So, yeah, I love being on stage, and yeah, it's an important part of my career, really, to keep doing that.
Are you looking forward to the film?
I am very much so, actually. Absolutely love the X-Men franchise, and I'm buzzing for it, in fact. Yeah, can't wait.
What do you love about X-Men?
I'm a bit of a nerd, to be honest. Like, closet nerd. Absolutely love, like, all the comics and stuff. I've watched, like, all the Origins, Wolverine and stuff like that, so I'm buzzing for it. It's a big part of my childhood as well, though, to be fair. Like, the films, the original ones, when I was, like, growing up, they were the films that I was able to see, and, yeah, great. Favorite character? Difficult question. Halle Berry, I mean, like Storm, of course, like she was hot. Her, and then also like Wolverine, of course, like he's savage character. Well, yeah, I run my own YouTube channel, so obviously get so much freedom to do stuff like this, get invited down to watch films, you know, ahead of release, which is obviously fantastic. What better way to spend my time than watching, you know, nerding it up with a little bit of X-Men, of course.
For people who haven't checked out your YouTube channel before, can you just tell us what it's all about? Tell us what kind of stuff they can see on there.
Yeah, well, you get to see a lot of my beautiful face, of course. Do a bunch of challenges, vlogs, and day-to-day like outgoings, all that great stuff, and also incorporate a little bit of the old gaming stuff. So yeah, you can expect to see a lot of that and a lot of also rage at some games that I'm not very good at. Best and worst game out at the moment would be FIFA 14 and FIFA 14. When it's good, it's good, and when it's bad, it's absolutely terrible.
What's so bad about FIFA 14? Because, I mean, it is one of the most enduringly successful sports franchises.
It is, but I think what it is that over time, they can get a little bit repetitive. Obviously, it's a football game, but the dynamic of it can get a little bit hard. Like, user, in terms of, like, they're trying to reach out to too many people, and so that can annoy some of the original FIFA fans. But obviously, they're bringing in like a massive, massive user interface as well. And the Xbox One's really helped with that, I think. There's a lot of different aspects to it. Like the Ultimate Team side of things that I like. There's a few little glitches that they don't seem to be able to bug out, which is like, again, it's quite a pedantic thing to get angry about. But the actual flow of the game, it's good. It's awesome.
I mean, you mentioned there, I mean, in terms of the next-gen consoles, who's coming out ahead in your book at the moment?
I'm an Xbox user. I've always been an Xbox user. However, I have to admit that I think the PS4 is probably a better gaming platform. The Xbox is better all in all sort of thing. Like, the actual interface is easier to use, I think.
What about new tech like Oculus Rift? I mean, how do you see that impacting gaming over the next 12 months?
You know, I haven't actually had a chance to have a go on Oculus Rift as of yet, but from what I've heard, it's going to be sensational. One of my friends actually had a go on it today, and so it was just like absolutely insane. It's going to take stuff to the next level. Well, I've just taken on the Ghost Chili Challenge, which was absolutely cataclysmic. It was undoubtedly the most painful thing I've ever been through in my life. It actually felt like a knife was going through like my intestine. It was horrible. Coming up next, I think I'm going to do a special video and try to incorporate several challenges at once. So you've got like the banana sprite, which I've already done, the ghost chili challenge again for my sins, cinnamon challenge, milk challenge. There's so many that out there to choose from. I'll just like take my pick and see what can be done. Shout out to everyone, subscribe to the Oakelfish channel, shout out to all my fish little army going on. Just keep doing what you're doing, and hopefully you're enjoying my content.
Yo, what's happening? It's Ashley Thomas, aka Bashy.
Ash, it's great to have you here tonight. You're an X-Men fan?
Yeah, huge fan. So I've watched all the X-Men's, and this series of them is just the best.
What makes this series the best? Why do you think this new version of them seems to have worked so well?
I think the drama, like, I think the characters have like a real sense of personality, and it just seems more genuine to me, more realistic.
You got a favourite X-Men character? Is there one you particularly like or identify with?
My favourite X-Men character of all time is Morph, because he could just become any of the characters, so I thought that was crazy.
What are you doing when you're not watching X-Men at the moment? What's coming up for you in 2014?
I'm working on my second album. At the moment I'm in the studio, and I've just been cast in a new BBC drama, so I'm waiting for that to come out. I start filming in June, and that'll come out in 2015.
Do you know when the album's going to drop yet? Have you got a release date?
No, I haven't got any release date for the album. Hopefully, like, I'm aiming for like January 2015.
How's it comparing to the first album? A bit of a different sound or more of the same?
Yeah, I'm older, I'm a bit more grown up. I've experienced more in life, so I just think that, you know, it's real, and I'm just talking about real stuff that everyone can relate to, because that's the stuff that I've gone through.
Working with anyone else on that? Is there anyone else we're going to recognise on the tracks?
Yeah, but I'm just going to keep those close to my chest because it's not finished yet. I don't want to say any of the names. Just you have to get everything signed off, and it's long.
About the BBC series, can you tell us anything about that, what it's about?
No.
Final question, you got a message for fans before you go and watch the film tonight?
Yeah, man, thank you for supporting me, man. Listen to real music. Big up.
Dan, you're looking forward to the film tonight?
Yeah, so much.
Are you a big X-Men fan?
Yeah, definitely. I even have a few comics.
If you were an X-Men, what superpower would you most want?
Wolverine. Wolverine's, yeah.
You're not watching X-Men, what's coming up for you at the moment? What are you busy with?
School, mostly. School and rugby, yeah.
What about acting and stuff? Any more of that coming up?
Not at the moment, no.
And have you got a message for fans before you leave us to go and watch the film tonight? Anything you'd like to say to them?
Not really, sorry.
Troy, are you looking forward to the film tonight? You're an X-Men fan?
Yes, I'm a very big X-Men fan. I've watched all of them, so no doubt I have to watch the new one.
What do you like about X-Men? What excites you about them?
You know, X-Men, you know, all of them have mutant superpowers, and, you know, as a magician, I'm always trying to show off my powers, so it's nice to see, you know, other powers and how they use them, and, you know, sometimes it can inspire me for a magic trick.
In terms of your own magic powers, when did you first discover them? When did you start your passion for magic?
When I was 12, I saw a magician on TV, and from there it was a no-brainer. I had to do magic. I love the idea of fantasy and making it come to life. So X-Men is a perfect film for me to watch.
What was the first trick you ever learned?
The first trick I ever learned was quite simple. It was a simple card trick. And then, you know, I learned to be a bit more creative and try to do magic with as much things as I can. So, yeah. But it's a card trick. That's my first trick, yeah. When I compare magicians with each other, it's like when I compare music artists. So you get like Kanye, you get Jay-Z. They're two established artists in their own right, and they deliver their music in different ways, although the foundation of what they do is the same. And I say that about me or any other magician. You know, the foundation of what we do is magic, but we deliver it and execute in our own way.
In terms of your repertoire now, what's your favorite trick? What do you love doing more than anything else?
It's difficult. There's a lot. Probably messing around with people's things. But it could be rent, it could be phone, money, credit card, something. I don't know. I've actually done a fashion campaign, which you'll see for autumn, winter. You see it all around. And working on the next series. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to be doing sort of for this year. But, yeah, there's loads of little things that you'll see me pop up on. So stay tuned.
In terms of the new series, what have you got in mind? Bigger and better?
You don't want to go too big. You don't want to make it unfeasible. You want to still want to make it fun and have everyone actually. Oh, sorry, just lost track there. It don't always need to be bigger. I just always want to sort of take it to the next level and just keep what people liked in the first series. They're in the second series as well. But you know, there's going to be brand new magic and. Yes, I don't want to give anything away. It's going to be a great series.
Just looking back at the first season, I mean, people loved it. For you personally, have you got a favourite moment, a favourite reaction on the show?
It's hard because, you know, to me, the show is like an album to me. And our artists will make a music album and there's a lot of tracks which are quite personal to them because they spent so long writing it or it's from a personal experience. It's like a lot of the magic that I made for the show is, you know, it took me a long time to think about and come up with. So a lot of it, when I perform it and get the reaction, it's like a good feeling. So everything that I've done in the show and people react to it, I can't really pick a favorite one. It's all good. Like any reaction's good to me. Because that's what you want to do as a magician, you want to provoke something, an emotion. And whether it's like a, or a, any is great. I don't have a particular favorite.
A lot of young fans watching you love your stuff and would love to be following in your magical footsteps. What advice would you give for people who are just starting out developing their own craft?
Just practice. You know, I started when I was 12 and all I did every day for hours and hours and hours was practice. And, you know, a lot of people will say there's only so far you can take something, but I always say the sky's the limit, you know. Just do what you want to do, live your dream, and I'm living mine. And there's no reason why, you know, another magician coming up can't live theirs.